The setup for the movie is that the Scrat is going to find a UFO embedded in the ice. And actually, this reaches back to the first film where we had a funny gag where the, you know, Manny, Sid, and Diego were walking through essentially an ice museum. And they pass this this UFO in the ice, and we always thought, oh, that's really funny. We should do something with that. So Scrat is going to find this thing. He's going to activate it by accident, and it'll be blasting off into the cosmos. And so while he's out there, he's going to bounce around off the planets and eventually send an enormous asteroid heading towards Earth on a collision course. And our main herd will come up with a crazy plan to try and stop it. I think with any great movie story, no matter what setting it is if it's the Ice Age from thousands of years ago or sometime in the future, you have to have real characters with real relatable dynamics and family issues. And I think that's been the real strength of the Ice Age franchise, is we've come from a great core, and every character we've added has been a very particular and special flavor that really makes these characters live and breathe. There's a lot of physical comedy that speaks across all languages, like that's common to everybody. And I also think that the issues that they've dealt with in terms of like the family growing and changing and evolving is also sort of a common human experience. We all know somebody like Sid or somebody like Manny somewhere in our family that speaks to us. So even though mammoths, you know, are from thousands of years ago, they've got something that relates to us. I came to Blue Sky in 1998, right out of college, and I interviewed at a bunch of different studios. I knew I wanted to be an animator, but there was something special about Blue Sky. I really felt that when I got here, there was an interesting family vibe, and I just loved the people, and I feel like we've been able to grow the team and, you know, retain essentially that spirit. So I've never wanted to leave. It's always been a great place.
What strikes a chord in people across the globe, I think, is just the essence of the herd, which is just about family and being there for each other. And no matter who you are or where you came from, what animal you are, it doesn't matter. They look out for each other and they're a family. We're so fortunate and lucky to be getting such great actors and actresses working with us. I mean, I think partially because every Ice Age movie always comes at you with a fresh new idea, a fresh new take, and fresh new characters. And so in that way, it feels like, you know, there's amazing roles to be filled. And, you know, we're very fortunate to have great actors and actresses work with us. It's an absolute joy to be part of this Blue Sky family. Having been here for over, I think, 17 years now, we've seen each other kind of grow along with our Ice Age characters. Probably one of my favorite things is working on the Scrat sequences. It always has been, but in this movie, taking him into the cosmos and exposing him to elements that he's never been exposed before has been really fun.
Hi, it's Valerie here with a little bit of love. Did you know the voice actors of Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse from the 1930s got married in real life? For this and more movie facts, click on more videos.